In a remote part of the South Pacific, three small islands are one of the last stands for the Hawksbill turtle. Three rival communities claim ownership of the islands. Their fishermen hunt the Hawksbill to the brink of extinction.
Hawksbill in place here too, you got people who come to harvest. Lay all but not the bones and everything. Eh?
The government steps in to protect the turtles, but the communities fight back. The turtles' very survival is in danger. So the communities sacrifice profit and set aside their differences to protect the turtles and their nesting beaches.
We look at that togetherness, oneness. Yeah?
Their story inspires conservation throughout the Pacific.
I think paradise come close up long past now.
It all starts with three small islands. Lying just north of Australia, the Solomon Islands are home to misty mountains covered with lush forests. And coral reefs teeming with fish. The Solomon Islands are full of life. Among the country's 900 islands, it could be easy to overlook three small ones. Kerihikipa, Sikapo and Malevona. They are the Anavan Islands. The islands range in size from 250 acres to 1200 acres. They may be small, but they're home to hundreds of species. The most endangered animal to call these islands home is the hawksbill turtle. The hawksbill spend most of their life at sea. They travel throughout the South Pacific, feeding in shallow reefs. But when it comes time to nest, they swim hundreds of miles back to the beaches they were born on, back to the Anavan Islands. These small islands are one of the most important rookeries for hawksbill in the world. Each year, females return to nest on these beaches by the hundreds. They lay their clutches of eggs and return to the sea. After 2 months nestled in the Anavan sands, it's time for the hatchlings to face the world. the journey ahead is dangerous. It will take determination and a little luck for these young turtles to survive and return to lay eggs of their own.
I mean, I'm also in one from bank. You place, I'm got plenty of resources.
Rent Zama is a fisherman from the nearby island of Choisil.
Oh, one day is normal, you pull my boom can. I'm placed in my valley for taking seleni and food.
Fishermen from three unique communities claim ownership of these islands. They are the communities of Kia, Katupika, and Vagina. Kia sits at the northern end of Santa Isabel Island, 15 miles east of the Anavans. The people of Kia have come to the Anavan Islands for centuries.
Time me small boy, my father always come up along here, Long Island, look at Hikapa. When my father come for fishing, look at him totally, awesome.
Chief Leslie Mickey is an important community leader.
My father follow timing no more, not every time. Time for my father ready for Christmas, time for ready for marriage, and the other very important days now my father have come, not all the time.
The Katupika live on the island of Choisil, 20 miles west of the Anavans. They are another community with long ties to the Anavan Islands. Their dances even include scenes of turtle hunting. The Gilbertese are the newest community to claim hunting rights to the Anavans. They live 6 miles west of the islands. They established the community of Vagina in the 1960s, after being relocated from their home on the Phoenix Islands in the nation of Kiribati. Tekia Akura represents his community. He is keenly aware of his Micronesian roots and how they differ from his Melanesian neighbors.
Lo Katupika, lo Wagina, and lo Kia. Different people all together with different culture all together.
Three communities, each claiming rights to the Anavan Islands, and each competing with the others for limited resources. Fishermen come to the Anuvans to catch tuna, grouper, and to harvest sea cucumber. But hawksbill turtles are the biggest prize.
I mean, hawksbill have one for important resource law that one.
Peter Ramo here monitors the population of hawksbill turtles.
Many coastal communities in Los Solomon Islands also rely on this resource for food and their livelihood.
Hawksbill turtles have been a commodity since the 1700s. But in the 1960s, the demand for turtle shell explodes. By the early 1980s, the hawksbill turtle is in grave danger. To save them, the Solomon Islands government places a ban on the sale and export of hawksbill from the Anuvans.
Okay, to West Block here, and me follow West Block. So when me follow claim him this one, also I'm island blow me follow. Me follow take him food and sell him lo him. Me follow no save now. Establish or this follow project him come down.
The communities that use the islands have no input on the ban. They are angry at losing an important resource.
Where now this project in form come? Longaman or low fisheries or local low province or who now man name doing this one?
Many oppose the heavy hand of government. Rents sets out to defy it. A small field station is the government's base of operations.
Second week, in January, law 82, me take a canoe with a outboard motor. Me come now, me come born in the house. I'm going to threshold, I'm going to report him, not cheap, blow me. House where you call a pride for bonding, I'm finished now.
Rents pays for his crime by spending almost 3 years in prison. He misses the birth of his son and the death of his father.
On behalf of the tribe, and the family, and the community, blow me, I'm proud. Yes, I'm not good something. From Banem down, but no another way more.
Rents is successful. The government pulls out and the fishermen return. For the next 10 years, the hunting continues without limit.
It's not much good, yeah? But I was spoiling now, surrounding what areas, yeah? I got the car at the time now, I got the trees here, I got the kill him, I got the hotel here. Lay all about now, got the bones and everything. Eh?
Lo here, broom here, harvest no any resource lo here. No? Since 80, kasem early 90, time big village stop lo here, no more. What me like for talent? I got spoiling place here too, I got people that come to him harvesting.
These idyllic islands are the scene of carnage. The population of hawksbill on the Anuvans drops by 80%. Worldwide, they are critically endangered.
Morally, I got a conviction that you are responsible, me responsible for her.
Williatu looks beyond the turtle's commercial value.
I saw something too much, but you know, I saw something else what the future generation will do. But I look at the paper, or I look at the textbook, I'm not got any life for him.
If him lose, I mean, everything here, him go with him. Yeah? I mean, food him lose, income him lose, culture him lose, everything him lose.
This ancient creature that has sustained these communities for generations is now at risk of extinction. Far from the islands, along the busy streets of the capital, Honiara, there is great concern for the hawksbill turtle. In a new effort to save the turtles, the Solomon Islands government partners with the Nature Conservancy to protect the turtles' nesting grounds on the Anavan Islands. This time, they invite the communities to participate and recognize their traditional ownership rights. It's the communities that will decide if conservation is to succeed.
Well, at the first meetings when we hold them, three communities, I'm like that people ought to cause a fight, yeah?
John Peter helps facilitate the early stakeholder meetings.
So I'm like Osem Yungorawa inside one courthouse. So I'm really challenging.
The meetings are contentious, but it's clear that if nothing is done, the turtles will be lost. Eventually, even those who oppose the earlier conservation efforts come to support the new ones.
If I start to round table about this fella area, with him over the ministries, with him over the partners outside, also me fella. Sit down together and me fella work out.
In 1995, the communities overcome cultural conflicts, past grievances, and disputes over land ownership to create the Anavan Community Marine Conservation Area. What started as an effort to save the hawksbill turtle is now 40,000 acres of protected land and sea. It's the first marine conservation area in the South Pacific.
Life blow you me human being one time. Okay, the creation we go to put in the sea and the land. Hey, connect.
Rents Zama, who had destroyed the first field station, is now building a new one. Rents has come to embrace conservation because he's part of the process and because he's concerned for the future.
Fusion generation blow three community now and very important on this project.
The Kia, Katupika, and Vagina communities are helping to manage the Anavans. Each sends a conservation officer who monitors the islands and protects the turtles.
All the community conservation officers are what represent them communities. They are the brains and the ways and the hands of what three communities. Mifla regard them what conservation officers lo here or some heart lo project. Without them, slow project but have no work.
Part of the management involves research. Conservation officers work with scientists to tag and monitor the turtles. The females come ashore to nest and are easy to tag. The juveniles and males stay offshore. So the conservation officers must go out and catch them. They call it the rodeo. The tags show that the hawksbill leave the Anavans and travel hundreds of miles to feed in Papua New Guinea, Australia, and New Caledonia. Events on the Anavans have far-reaching consequences.
So meet like for Talemi on that Tottenham come by. Win him last time. Ting blow me suppose this project him no start. I mean him no stop lo here. No man total come lo here. No man.
Success in the Anavans has inspired conservation throughout the Solomon Islands. The community of Zinowa sits along the south coast of Choiseul. Its fish stocks are in steep decline.
Until 2004, so everything, people no sabe, mi fal no sabe manage him. So marine resources him destroy.
Chief Ledley Madoko visits the Anavans and is impressed by what he sees.
Time come up long Anavan Island, me look him staka, everything come up good. What them come in my mind? Mind blow me, and me say, I think best way me fala should keep him marine resources blow me fala. Or same long Anavona. Like one time with him Anavona.
The community of Zinowa establishes a protected area and bans all fishing within its boundaries.
When we start to close the island, yeah? Everything come grow. We fish stuck, clam shells stuck, and we feel happy too. Happy with them, everything come good.
The story of conservation is reaching deep into the mangroves, to the village of Poroporo.
Well, like looking, what water old man looking come before, yeah. The big one water story. Yeah.
Timothy Tokai is a village elder.
This time, people like looking long high now, what people hearing.
They put a complete closure on hundreds of acres of reefs and mangroves. Now, fish fill the waters and birdsong fills the air.
I think paradise come close up long past now.
Since the Anavan Islands were first protected, over 10 other communities have established their own conservation areas. Positive change is happening, but there are still challenges. Some fishermen struggle to feed their families. Otea Bay is one of them.
But I'm true something up. Suppose if you follow the dive every day, them. But I'm hard for anything. I'm because I'm not life long follow. No matter if I spoil them or whatever. But,
Replacing income lost from the bans is a key to sustaining conservation efforts.
When auto do conservation, auto close them auto resources for no harvest them, auto expect them something in return.
The Vagina community is generating a new source of income. They are farming seaweed and selling it to international markets. Revenues from this new harvest are relieving some pressure to hunt. But there may be one threat beyond anyone's control.
Hello, experience for me. I'm very true. Now, the scientists talk about global warming. I'm very true. See, I'm go through. Spoil them, got a tree, got a coconut, stand up here, down everywhere.
Across the Solomon Islands, the sea claims more and more land each year. On the Yarnavans, sea level rise is eroding hawksbill nesting beaches. Conservation officers must move threatened nests to higher ground.
It's like climate change where I'm caused by big countries. I'm affecting Mifala, where Mifala no serve anything or contribute for causing this climate change happen.
The hawksbill turtle continues to face many challenges. But their nesting grounds on the Anavan Islands are protected. And the communities that once hunted them are now working for their survival.
Looking back to the early days, I mean the past, and since this project came to start, for preserving the resource we have got him put them and create them, we got a blessing on him. We got a blessing on him.
I believe Anavan by him go ahead yet. Because something has embedded inside the hearts of the people.
Even culture is different, language is different, lifestyle is different. But since this was Anavan established, we look at that togetherness is not there. Oneness, yeah?
Now there is unity where there was conflict. There are healthy turtles and reefs where there was devastation. And there is hope for conservation in a world with many challenges. The Anavan Islands are living proof.